Everybody have a good detour?
Yeah.
That's basically these last panels are for. It's like, you know, you're kind of tired, you're done, you know, whole convention, final panel. Let's go. All right. Hello, guys.
Hello.
Welcome to How to Be a Real Life Magical Girl. As you can see, we've got two real life magical girls to tell you how to be a real life magical girl. But basically, I mean, this panel is going to be more like how I think you can live your life as a real-life magical girl, but then also we can just talk about magical girls in general because the genre is like a huge series that's really fun to talk about, so. Yeah, cool. So, alright. First off, what are your favorite magical girl series? Let's go. Alright, raise hands, come on, let's go. You right there.
Princess Tutu.
Ah, great. Wow, that's a good one. Me too.
Pretty Soldier Sailor Moon.
Let's see how far we can go. You know how many magical girl series are out there? My favorite is Shuashara. I'm sorry, guys. I love that show. It's a guilty pleasure sort of thing. You too?
My first one was Tokyo Mew Mew.
Tokyo Mew Mew. Alright, you?
I'm pointing right at it.
Madoka?
Well, Madoka Madoka Magica.
Woohoo!
Say the whole thing.
Mako Shoujo Madoka is Madoka.
Mako.
Doki Doki Lesbian Magic.
Oh, no.
I mean, that's my name. Oh, shit. I'm despairing.
No, don't go, I can't despair. Alright. So, here we go. So now we talk about our favorite magical little series.
Any more? Just yell them out.
Come on.
Pretty Cure.
Yeah.
Utana.
Cool. Yeah, we got a time manga this weekend.
Simple
gear. Simple gear.
That counts.
It totally counts.
Magic Knight Rayer.
Card Captor Sakura!
Magic Knight Rayer.
Yeah, good. So guys, alright. Now we're going to talk about some real-life magical girls. I think the closest thing to a real-life magical girl, like in our current day setting, is kind of like pop stars, if you think about it. Because they have this persona that's not really who they are, but they transform and like sing. And also a lot of magical girl series are like, you know, there's a lot of singing involved, and idol anime is another like sub-genre if you want to think about it that way. So what do you guys think about that? Pop stars and magical girls? I mean, some cool outfits and glitters and songs.
By an extension, yeah.
By an extension.
Or like those like girl idol groups. That's like a whole team of magical girls.
I know. Like, if you guys watch those, those are incredible. They're all like dancing in unison and matching outfits and cat ears. It's insane. It's a thing to do on my list. Things to do before I die. Go to one of those idol pop shows. But guys, wait. Ready to twist your brains even further? I feel like Thor. Because, I mean, this panel is like, you know, all genders, all ages, no contracts. So, I mean, if you think about it, I think if you go down to like what magical girl is, it's basically like just someone who tries to help people. And there's also like, you know, the transformation bubble. That's not always like a thing in every single. Wait, we want to see, like, I have a whole list of people that I think I could consider magical girls, but now that I've got you guys all thinking about it, maybe we can start using these prizes. So this whole bag of Korean candy, it's really delicious. I actually bought all this stuff from, like, Oriental Market close to my house, so I'm going to pay the prices here. So, guys, just think about that for a second. Open this bag. Informative, it's pretty casual. We can like just discuss stuff, you know? So hey, anyone have any ideas? Who you think you consider real life magical girls? Alright, go. Give her two candy.
I am going to. She's like the first one
Yeah, Carrie is really cool. Wait, can we just talk about her for a little bit? She's like, I mean, alright, so there's a little, you know, the Pon Pon video, right? That's like her first splash of thing. But all the videos she's made, like, you know, like, since then have been like, you know, she's come full circle. Anyone see her newest video? I'm not a Carrie expert, so I cannot, like, be completely. Did anyone see your newest video? You did? Or, you know. Because she goes through all of her outfits that she's worn in her past music videos and, like, says goodbye to them. It's a whole cycle. It's very cute.
But also, like, she puts on that persona, but, like, I've read interviews about her, and she, like, really doesn't like being touched. And I think that's part of being a magical girl, is that they're flawed, but they don't let you know that.
Oh. Yeah. Kind of like a whole, like, transformative thing and helping people. All right. They're gonna more about what cool lots of hands. All right, let's go with Pinky.
With Tony Stark.
No. Tony Stark. Well, hey, stress. We got an Iron Man suit. He does. Well, I mean, yeah, does good. I mean, it's pretty.
He's flawed when he's Tony, but flawless when he's Iron Man.
It's pretty good. Okay. Okay. You got a lot of people now. All right. Let's see. How about you? Yeah, you.
How about Hatsune Miku? She kind of changes persona between videos and the cute outfits and everything.
Vocaloid, if you want to get into that, you know, there's, oh my god, how many Miku Hatsunes are there? I mean, we got, like, every single video song with its own subplot, and if you want to get into, like...
Don't you have a figure of someone cosplaying?
Dude, Lucky Star OVA, Kagamiku, Kagami is Miku. That was an accident. Okay. Homura, over there. Marina. Alright, who knows who Marina is from Me and the Diamonds? Okay, she's really cool. I feel like she's just so elegant, I would consider her almost like a magical girl.
And she has, like, her different personas, too.
But, I mean, that's not it. We're just talking about, like, you know, just transform and stuff. But I feel like you also need to, like, do, you know, be like a super good person too, or like have, like, you have to give something out to people. Her songs are really like empowering to women, so I feel like that's a really great thing to give out to the universe.
Fucking Miku.
All right, let's keep going. All right, you right here.
Kind of on that note, and on a personal note, Lindsay Stirling, the violinist. So, like, I hadn't played my viola in like 10 years until I became a fan of her and, you know, finally dusted the thing off. Got like a tuner for it, and now I play every day.
That's cool. That's good. Inspiration. That's awesome. I like that a lot. You back there.
Daft Punk.
Oh. I was about to say Daft Punk.
She loves Daft Punk.
I was about to interrupt you and say Daft Punk because I like that guy. Can I say this too?
Sure. I mean, there's two members in Daft Punk. I mean, cool.
There really are.
Okay, Lucy.
It's more of a category, but like, beauty pageants to an extent, because I was a massive tomboy and I went into a beauty pageant at my school, and after that I gained a lot of confidence from it, and a lot of them give back to the community and help out at events.
Exactly! That's good.
That's how you be a real life magical girl in your life.
And there's also, like, you know, there's like talent involved too, because there are those portions, and then you also, like...
And you get to wear the evening dress.
I know, I like that example, that's a very good one. Alright, you in the front, are you?
I think drag queens are kind of like real life magical
girls. Oh, yeah. I would agree with that.
They transform, and then they, like, do sassy things on stage, and they feel happy, and then they make them
look good. That's good. Oh, I like that too. Cool. Can I use back there?
Corrupted magical girls, Justin Bieber.
Oh, God.
You have to argue that. You have to argue that a little further.
Oh. He inspires me every day.
Justin is like an example of how not to be a magical girl.
Yeah.
Like, well, he had the opportunity and he missed it.
Yeah, he starts off...
He kept it for a little while, you know, inspiration people. Don't do drugs. Well, it's that one. So. You know, crash magical girl. Alright, you are here.
I feel Loki is a real life magical girl because he does actually take on different people's appearances and act as them, and he doesn't do good, but he kind of does in certain moments. He decides to do good things.
Kind of ambiguous. Like, Loki's moral ambiguity.
Yeah, that's cool. You are here.
He-Man
and...
Oh! He-Man!
I like that.
I'm probably going to get hit for this one, but I really think that he is, in a way, but anyone knows the singer from Black Veil Bride, Andy Gierza, because his music inspires so many people that he's living every day, and it's just very inspiring for his fans.
Okay, cool. Thank you for coming. Alright. You've been waiting for a long time.
Aaron Yeager.
Aaron Yeager! Hello. You get this kiwi pudding for calling Aaron Yeager a magical girl. That's good. Well, wow. That's good. It's got everything you've talked about so far. Anyone, like, not argue that? Hello, welcome new members. Welcome to Hubby Real Life Magical Girl. This is a really casual last panel of Detour. We're all like chatting about our favorite magical girls. And right now, we're talking about real life people we feel like could like, what real life magical girls that exist in our world or not. Like,
not necessarily also, girls, so it's more like...
It's more like a, you know, general thing. It's a feeling getting hard. We got a lot. You in the blue shirt.
I feel like it's more of a group, but like police, firefighters, soldiers, people like that spend time fighting for what's right.
Exactly. The hardworking people that do what's right. You can say that about like everybody. If, for example, you know, that person in Chipotle is getting you their burrito, they are working really hard to make you that delicious burrito, and you're going to eat it, and you're like, oh, it's so good. Yeah, people in food service that like do things to make you happy, and the firefighters and policemen that save people, that's a pretty drastic way to make you happy with your life. Like, it's cool. Okay, let's go. Your hand's really high over there.
Okay, I was going to say Carrie Savage. You know, she does a lot of charity work outside of this.
A lot of charity work, that's really good too. I mean, obviously, like, we've been talking a lot about the transformative part and being magically cool, but, like, the helping part is really, like, what magical girls do. Okay, all right. Sayaka.
SGPS is sound, but my mom is a magical girl. Aww. Because she, even though she doesn't really understand the cosplay and stuff, she will humor me and watch anime with me, and she, like, never even makes me up the con, and she'll find it later, and I'm like, you know, but I enjoy your presence.
Oh, that's good. Give her a pudding too. That's really nice. Oh, good. That's a clap for all parents. Okay. All right. Homura.
I think that Ellen
DeGeneres. I was gonna say Ellen. Cool. Oh, I like that one too. All right. Mankato sweatshirt.
Thank you. I think that teachers are magical girls because their power is in teaching us, and the ones who get really into their role, I will always remember my fifth grade teacher who pretended she was Queen Elizabeth and came in for an interview, and it was just so, I mean, there you have the transformation and the power of the party college, and I think that's really special.
That is really special. Teachers as magical girls. I really feel that. I'd watch that. If that was an anime, I'd watch that real fast. They all teach you something different? Oh, it'd be good. Someone make that. All right, orange shirt. Oh, magic school bus. Perfect.
There was a Miss Frizzle here last year.
Yeah, I saw her. I saw her Friday.
There was one Friday.
Oh, I missed her on Friday, but I saw her.
I think
last
she was
year.
Saturday too, in a different dress even.
Oh, no one said Beyonce. I feel like she's more like a cosmic, you know, like ultimate magic. All right. Okay, come run. Nicki Minaj. All right, red shirt.
Cosplayers in general.
All right, now that leads up to my... We'll have more time. Mudoka!
Okay,
all right. So we've been doing a few panels where it's like, we all had the candy, and they're just going to like keep chucking the candy. And that endangers people.
If people like throw it too high and it like bounces off the ceiling, that's so scary.
Oh, wow.
I'm sorry, I won't throw anymore.
Yeah, stop. Okay, so that leads up to the next thing I want to talk about is like how you can be a real-life magical in your everyday life. I think there are four levels of being a real-life magical girl. Okay, are you ready?
Okay.
There's invisible magical girl, subtle magical girl, and I am magical girl, okay? So, we'll begin. Invisible magical girl is like, you know, you are just someone, you know, you just smile at people, maybe compliment them every so often. If there's a piece of trash on the ground, you might pick it up. You know, it's really subtle, like, good citizen things. Just being a good person in general. Do you have an invisible magical girl? Or like, you know, have you ever had, like, people just do randomly nice things? You're opening the door. That is the first step to being a real-life magical girl. Do you have to agree with that? Invisible magical girl? And then, like, subtle magical girl is going up to, like, you know, you do volunteer work, you're helping animals, you help your sister with homework, maybe you're a teacher, you know, like, subtle magical girl, we're continuing with that. And then, all right, so you gotta kind of get what that category is about. And then for I am magical, wait, there's magical girl before I am magical girl. Magical girl is just, like, That's my in-between I am magical girl. Because I am magical girl is like,
you are
a magical girl. You are the stereotypical magical girl. You walk around, there are sparkles wherever you are. People see you and they smile because they're like, look at that. Look at that magical girl. So anyway, that's what I aspire to be, magical girl. Or kind of like where you think about, we used the example of pop stars earlier. Like you look at them, you kind of get like a celestial fear. The more if you've been to a concert that really has impacted you or something, like that's kind of like the I am magical girl level.
Marina
2013. Hey, you guys feel me on that? It's kind of cool. And then like the magical girl in between is just kind of like the in between of subtle invisible and I am.
It's like I am magical girl without the cool wardrobe.
Yeah. Oh yeah, and then like, you know, you can like buy cute stuff to be magical girl, like Lolita fashion is, you want to be like, don't look like magical girl, you can go into that if you want. That's really cool. But yeah, I think singing also is pretty magical girl like. Glitter, talent, helping people, you know. Good. Maybe you can get more ways to give up these prizes.
I just ate one.
Stop. okay. Alright, let's see. You know what I really like talking about? I like talking about people in anime that aren't magical girls, but I consider magical girls. Like, for example, if we want to talk about...
Lelouch!
I was even going to Neon Genesis Evangelion! Because they get into their robots and help people.
You're not robots, Hannah!
Helping people?
Are we going to have spoilers for 25-year-old series? I don't know. No, good. You want to talk about that?
Yes.
I'll open up the floor about anime characters that are not magical girls, we feel like are magical girls.
Eren Yeager?
Alright, Eren Yeager's our first one. That was pretty good. Also, just Thor. That's not anime. Who cares? Alright, you over here. Selty from Durara. We could talk about her. Who likes Durara? I do. Second season coming out. It's pretty exciting.
It is?
Yeah. So.
Oh. You're Justice. Sorry.
Yeah, she's in drama. She's mysterious and she does favors for people without like people really like knowing or really appreciating, but she's all like, you know, in the shadows, that's her whole deal. So that's kind of my levels of magical girl. That's like subtle magical girl. Okay, we got a lot going on now. You in the back there, curly
hair. Alex Louise Armstrong.
Thank you. Yes. Yes.
He sparkles! How can you miss it?
Cool.
He inspires people to greatness with his muscles.
Would these muscles lie?
Okay, flower crown right here.
Armin from Attack on Titan. Yes!
Armin from Attack on Titan. I mean, when you compare him to Eren, I mean, that's two different levels of magical girl.
He's so intelligent and he just inspires.
Armin would be like the subtle magical girl.
Yeah.
And it's like, he would be.
Good. Alright, I like that. I agree with that. Armin is subtle, Eren is I am. Okay, you over there.
Yeah.
I know. I know. My Madoka's got some things about Kill la Kill, so we will not be discussing Kill la Kill at this panel. But I personally totally agree with you with the transformative. Definitely. Okay. All right. You with the sunglasses. There. Yeah, you.
Nia from Gurren Lagann.
Yeah. Oh, she's cute. I like her too. Okay, Kyubey. Oh no, you're Kyubey. You are the Pokemon. I'm so
sorry.
Forgive me.
Yeah.
I knew you.
Mirai from Kyokai no Kanata.
Yes! I want to talk about her because Mirai, Kyokai no Kanata. Who's seen Kyokai no Kanata? Good series. Came out last year. One of my favorites, personally. But yeah, she has like. She's kind of like, you know, the klutzy, cute schoolgirl or whatever, but then she like fights off. That sounds like a lot of anime characters, but. Yeah, it's Sakura.
Sora! Hearts.
Yes!
Because he goes to every world and helps everyone out, and my friends are my power. That's straight from a magical world.
Hey, wait, I have an idea. You know what could be more interesting? Would it be cool if we had two people come up and argue why their anime character is more magical girl? Would that sound cool? That's cool? Okay. I need a time limit.
Each person should get 30 seconds, so think about your magical girl and why they're the most magical girl.
And they could be someone we've talked about, because we've had a lot of really good examples. But I mean, don't just scrape steel for someone, I guess, you know? Alright, I'll set this up. And then now we have the opportunity to give away these cool things.
Now we have
look at these cool things. Look at this. We have Hello Kitty Pock.
Yams.
No.
Was I a pock?
Yeah, and then. Oh no, Madoka. Okay.
Double chocolate Halloween.
Yeah, it's okay, so it's not just chocolate. It's double chocolate because the actual cookie is chocolate too.
Puns.
All right. Good. Cool. I got our timer ready. All right, let's raise hands. Who thinks they've got the best argument? How about, like, most enthusiasm gets to go first?
Woo!
Okay. All right. All right, let's have you right there with both arms, and then Hidoki, pick the next one.
No, okay. Put your hands down, and then on the count of three, give me your most enthusiastic reveal.
One,
two,
three.
What are you guys?
That, you. You were way good.
Okay, all right, good. We'll do this a lot. We've got a lot here.
Yeah,
so.
Okay.
One second. Yeah, okay, ready? All right,
okay.
So think about it. All right.
Okay, so you each get 30 seconds, then.
Do you want to have two microphones for each person? That sounds kind of cool.
Hey, we have two microphones.
Yeah, we do.
Miss Mules. Okay. All right. Does this work? All right, good. Don't stand too close to the speakers. Good. All right. Madoka, you hang it over here. Okay. Are you ready?
Should they say the names first?
Oh, yeah. First, state your name of your magical girl you'd like to argue. Not really magical girl.
Yeah. I don't know how many people have seen it, so the newer series, Silver Spoon, Hachiken, is a magical girl.
Yeah!
Alright, mine's not really well known, but the Kusuri Uri from Mononoke.
Yeah.
Alright, so we have 30 seconds, and the first person will argue, next person will argue, and then we'll have a little bit of time to counter. Ready?
So,
three, two, go.
So Hachiken has totally transformed himself from this guy who knew nothing about agricultural school or farming or anything like that. So he like gets himself into this world he totally doesn't know about. He has like the farm uniforms and all that he has to put on. But the biggest deal is that he's just like always putting himself out there, always getting people on projects, and always inspiring other people to get behind him. And he's making the school a better place and kind of just showing everybody what, you know, what sort of life can be. He makes everything.
Alright, good, that was 30 seconds.
Wow,
awesome. Alright, ready? And go.
Okay, so the Kusuri Uri, he goes around as a medicine seller, nothing more. And he'll go find people who are in trouble, like they don't know they're in danger yet, but he knows. And he'll fight off the monsters, which includes a very flashy transformation sequence into this golden guy. One of his big themes is helping women who've been wronged. And he has all these magical powers and these scales that help him find where the monster is and so on and so forth.
All right, good. Excellent. Now, cool. How about, let's do this. We'll have an audience vote. We'll do that. So we have, like, you know, hands. That sound fair? Sounds good? All right, now. Wait, do you guys want to counter? We were going to do that.
Rebuttal? I think I'm okay.
You're okay? Okay. We don't really need to, because they're both good. Like, we're both arguing about good people, so it's like, why would you want to...
Everyone's
winning.
And I also like her, so I don't
want to
talk about, like, not
even answering. I know. This is good. I like that. Okay. All right. So.
Should the audience pick?
For this first one, because you guys both agree that you're both very good magical girl people, we'll both give you candy.
Okay.
Yay!
That's a very
magical girl.
That's very good. All right. Thank you. Okay, alright. Now. Okay.
Oh, he's doing fingers.
Okay, wait,
she's
I'm
on the chair.
Alright, I think Palmer over there. Hang your turn. Okay.
Come on.
Fingers.
Damn it.
Okay.
Gotta do the challenge, people.
Okay. Alright, welcome up.
Holding fingers.
Alright, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to argue that Naruto Uzumaki is the greatest knucklehead magical girl of all time. Going to town, doing good, and making new friends along the way. He uses multiple transformation sequences and more than a fair amount of fan service. Generating more yaoi than many of other things combined.
Wow. Alright, I will have to agree with that, so... but I think I'm gonna move into the video game area and say that Samus from Metroid is totally a magical girl because, one, she has her power suit and her zero suit form, so different forms. And also, I think what's really inspirational about her is that you don't know she's a girl until the very end of the video game, so she can totally kick ass throughout the whole video game, save the universe, regardless of gender.
Perfect.
Alright, now that's our closing argument. You go first.
All right. Using only a team of well-accessorized friends, we can all admit that Naruto, well, is far superior in this regard. And you better believe it. Because he will do good.
Alright, I guess Samus has been one of the bigger video game characters for the past how many years? I'm pretty sure most of us pretty much know who they are. So I think that kind of speaks for itself. Okay, good. So you can't, excellent, good job, guys. Okay. Now, who feels Naruto?
Come on, let's see those hands.
Wow, this is who I need to count. Okay, all right. Who feels Metroid? Wow, whoa. We are joined.
Okay, before we get to redo that, I'm going to have to count.
Wait,
it's all in the sales.
Just do like a noise thing. Like, we'll cheer for the one we want.
Okay, all right. Naruto is Maki. Samus from Metroid. You get to choose one of these fabulous prizes. Great, thank you, Kamara. Alright, who's ready to go next? Ooh, okay.
We've got some
enthusiasm. I'm
Alright, okay, I am picking you. You come up here. Your turn.
This is all magical.
And you on the chair.
Excellent, alright. Okay, now.
Bring the bronze.
Alright, ready? Go.
I'm going to say that Monkey D. Luffy from One Piece is the best magical girl ever. Not only does he have several different transformations, he's gathered an entire crew of friends that spend their entire time going around the world just solving people's problems. That's all they do. And they all have various magical and strength-based abilities that they use, combining them together to create wonderful things for everyone they meet.
Perfect. Alright, thank you. Go.
Okay, I was Saragaki from Dramatical Murder because he has an utterly ended suffering for all of the characters in his game, and every route he solves their problems, and in his own route he solves his own problems. And he also has a little critter friend, you know, Ren, that's a really cute dog. And he has magical powers himself, like his voice is magic, and he goes into people's minds, and that's where he saves them. Like, he literally, like, reaches into their hearts, and he pulls out all of their pain and just throws it away. It's like,
wow,
great.
And he has a cute outfit.
And he's like, he's blue.
All right, there we go.
He has a mullet.
All right, thank you. Now, closing argument.
The Straw Hat Pirates aren't even trying to solve problems. That's the thing about them. That's why they are so awesome, and Luffy especially, because he's the leader, but they are so amazing, they aren't even trying to solve problems. They're just trying to get to the end of the Grand Line, but as they go, just by being there, they solve problems for the people that are around them. And that's why Monkey D. Luffy is the best magical girl.
Okay, Awa doesn't even go around trying to solve problems either. Like, they just fall in his lap, and he's like, what is this? And he fixes it, and he's a great guy! And he has, like two friends, because that's not a good argument. He has five boyfriends.
Okay, all right, we've got... Wow, this is a good one. Alright, we've got our One Piece pirate.
Luffy!
Heck yes! Alright, ready? Alright, 3, 2, 1. Luffy. And then
mullet.
Murder.
His mullet.
3, 2, 1. Alright. Here you are. You're feeling more love for Luffy. That was good. You guys were awesome. Good job, guys. Losers get candy too.
Losers get candy.
They're all winners. Okay, are we ready to go again? Okay.
I have the best idea.
Okay, wait. All right.
I have the best idea.
Everyone, sit down. Sit down. And now, all right. Okay, I'm gonna count down to three.
Count down to three.
Yeah. 3, 2, 1.
Me! I have, okay, alright, here we go.
Oh my gosh. I'm going to pick...
I'm flailing over here!
Alright, you over there.
He's gonna hurt himself.
Okay. I'm going to hurt myself!
Alright, now it's time for the
overtake. One, two, three!
Oh my gosh! Please!
Alright, there we go. Okay. Alright, come on, you cute girls. Let's go. Alright, now are you guys ready? I'm gonna get out of here. Alright. 3, 2, 1, go.
Okay, I think Kirby is the best magical girl because not only does he go around and suck up all the monsters in the world, he goes and has fun with like all of his Kirby friends. And there's multiple different Kirbys if you've ever played the games. So you can basically just go in a group of Kirbys and just save the world.
Good. Good. All right. Your turn. I believe that the doctor is the... because he goes around to every world in the universe and helps everybody, and even though, like, he doesn't, like, mean to go there, he just takes it out of his heart, and he's like, well, okay, you know, there's a problem, I guess I would put them against my needs. So,
yeah.
Alright, good, thank you. Thank you both, it was good. Now, closing statement.
I also think that Kirby goes to different universes because there's pretty much like a whole bunch of different worlds that he goes to, and he has his own starships. Kirby Air Ride. Love that
Starship
game.
TARDIS. Oh.
So,
TARDIS is female.
Also, Kirby doesn't have a gender.
Okay. All right. Continue. Doctor.
The doctor has two hearts.
That's pretty magical girl. Alright, let's make some noise. Who thinks Kirby is the best magical girl? Who thinks the doctor is the best magical girl? That was pretty good. I like that example. Alright, shake hands, you guys. That was pretty cool. That's good. Now here you go. Choose. Select. Oh, good. No! Alright. No, guys, are you ready? Alright, we're gonna do this again. Here we go. Okay. 3, 2, 1.
Oh my gosh. Yes, please!
Okay,
I know it!
A sweatshirt.
Yay!
I'm flailing again!
Okay.
He's flailing again!
Calm down, y'all. Calm down, y'all. Okay. 1, 2. Oh, okay, you're already.
Thank you.
We're friends, so this is actually perfect.
Oh! Ooh! Here we go! How's this working? Alright, ready? It's gonna get real. Okay, alright. Are you ready to begin?
I am ready.
Alright, begin.
The entire female cast of AKB0048. Because not only do they transform into their outfits and dance and sing, their music, their microphones turn into lightsabers, so they have their own weapons, and they can like shoot hearts out of their eyes and stuff, and they have the little kiraras going like ee! All over and around themselves, and their whole purpose is to spread happiness and entertainment to the entire world.
Let's go. Okay, your turn, go.
Okay, I pick Kite from the Dot Hack video games, because in the real world, he's just an average guy whose name actually escapes me at the moment, but in the game, he does everything, he solves problems as mundane as helping his best friend get in good with his digital lover, and to fighting and defeating enemies with infinite HP.
Good.
Right. Kite is Hackroots.
Dot Hack, the video games, the first four.
Yeah, but which of the anime franchises featured him?
One of them did.
Is it Legend of the... Was it Twilight? Or was it...
Okay.
Or was it... I can't remember.
I guess...
Or you do not remember either. I don't know. It's been a long time.
Well, no, okay, so there was Dot Hack Sign.
Yes, that was a good one.
Then there were the games.
Which aren't that great.
Whoa!
Super anime. I have a question. I gotta know.
You use Data Drain on it.
Yeah, so he has a magical transformation called Data Drain where he just makes them mortal and then slays them.
Okay.
But the thing is, Kite's trapped, right? So he can't solve his own problem.
He's a guy, and yet he's as adorable as any magical girl.
Yeah, but AKB0048's girls have like hearts in their hair and hearts in their eyes and, you know, multicolored hair that like shines and glistens, and when they dance it's like sparkles all over.
Look, honestly, don't have to interject. We have to cut this to close
votes. He said it can eat it.
Alright, okay, final closing statement. You have go.
all the AKB0048 girls want is for all of you to be happy.
I think, wait, I just want to add something. In their anime, isn't it like idols and the music is against the law?
Yeah.
Like, entertainment is banned. You can't be happy. You can't have entertainment.
So they're like going against the law and they want everyone to be happy.
Like, this anime. Like, guys, this anime. There are signs in the city that say, no idol. And their idols everywhere.
It's just like,
they're like against the law and fighting space just for happiness. It's pretty cool. Now your turn.
Kind of acquired his powers at a church.
Appeal to Jesus. Okay. All right, here we go.
Jesus.
All right. AKB. Dot
hack. I don't know what to do.
Shake hands and both of candy. That was entertaining. Okay. I like that. Good job, guys. Yes.
Okay.
All right. Thank you, guys. Okay, who's ready? Keep going.
Yeah.
I'm so ready.
I'm top of the world.
You go. Get up.
Calm down. 1, 2, 3.
I am so ready right now.
Okay. So ready. Right
he
now.
Is so ready. You've been so ready for a while. Let's just get up here.
Wait, guys.
I'm so incredibly ready.
All right. Here we go. Ooh. I'm sorry I called you cute.
Okay.
Alice, forgive me.
I apologize. Okay.
I ain't no dragon type.
Okay.
It's okay, I'm a sugar-coated murder machine.
Okay.
Magical girl in my own right.
Alright, start. Go.
Alright, so I'm gonna piggyback off the Kingdom Hearts thing and choose Aqua from Birth by Sleep. Not only does she first become a Keyblade Master, her friends become totally pissed off and her hate her guts. What does she do? Go through all of the worlds helping solve other people's problems and then trying to save her friends from their deaths and in the end sacrifices herself in an attempt to save them.
Stick it on. More
alright, anyway. I really think that, obviously, the best magical girl of all time is Phoenix Wright.
Yeah.
I mean,
objection.
You start thinking about, like, who is the ditziest, most airheaded person in the world, and then when he steps behind that bar, when he gets going, he will defend and protect the defenseless and unprotectable.
Mm.
He will beat prosecutors who have literally never lost a case in their lives, and he will take them down, and he will protect the innocent, and he will find the truth.
That's good.
And his normal form is pretty pathetic, and he looks pretty snazzy in his suit, so I think it speaks for itself.
All right, here we go. Closing statements. Go.
Disney.
Objection!
Strong closing arguments. All right, are you ready? Our Kingdom Hearts Magical Girl. Phoenix Wright. That was very good, guys. Alright, choose your prize. This is a mango steam. It's interesting. No, lychee. I love lychee.
Like strawberry coffee.
That's
good. Take that.
I will bring happiness to all.
You can become a magical girl.
I will become
Mabuka.
Alright.
Okay.
Let's keep going. This is kind of fun. I like this.
I have a good point tonight.
Yes. Oh, you're just a point in general?
I would like to argue Edward
Elric. Edward
Elric,
get up here.
Okay. 1, 2, 3, press me!
Woo!
Okay. Get up here!
Sure.
Okay, here we go. Alright, you first. Are you ready?
Yeah,
go.
I'd like to argue Aang from Avatar.
Oh!
Aang and Elric! Man!
Oh!
Alright, go.
Okay, so Aang just chills around and he has his own magical powers. He has all the magical powers because that's why he's the leader. And he has like a fabulous arrow on his head and like everybody from his team has their own like element. So it's like they're all coordinated and they go around solving problems in every single town.
Alright, ready, go.
Okay, so I would like to argue Edward Elric as the first thing is that he selflessly tries to, you know, bring back his mom just because he misses the poor lady. And then in the process, you know, he does end up a little bit mangled, but then the entire time, he's just basically trying to help his brother. He will literally sacrifice himself for his brother, and then what does he do for that? He goes in the military, and through his adventures, fights for every person that he ever meets, and whatever problems they have, he always finds a solution for them. And if you want to go with the transformation throughout the entire series, he's always...
Transmutation.
And all of his comrades, you know, obviously alchemy, they're, you know, magical sequences and, you know, bright lights, and right. It's fabulous.
Thank you. Good. All right. Closing statement.
Well, he has his own transformation. I mean, the Avatar state, so...
Yeah, Avatar.
It's pretty badass.
I mean, pretty important.
So. He died once in that, though.
He died more than once.
He's like Goku, I guess.
Okay,
Well, Edward did transcend entire realms to fight for his brother, so that's a good point.
Okay. Yeah, go.
Did you guys see the Edward Elric Sailor Moon AMV in the AMV contest?
No. That's pretty cool. Someone edited like Edward Elric to the Sailor Moon opening. It was really impressive. I was like, oh wow.
That's another good point.
Okay. Alright, now let's vote. Here we go.
Aang.
Aang. Edward Elric. Alright, here you are. Yes, my choice. Cool. Alright, we have two more rounds left. These better be good.
And we got two more. Oh, we can keep going forever.
We really have a lot of plans.
We have tons of, you guys having fun?
We have tons of candy, we have tons of time, and a detour. Let's go. So, okay. Alright, you.
Okay. 1, 2, 3! That guy. I think it was
the point. Oh, more friend fights. I like these.
I love friend fights.
Oh, God.
Michael?
Good one. Okay,
right,
are we ready? Alright.
Alright. So I say Goku is the best magical girl of all time.
Yeah!
Everyone has to have transformation, right? Well, Goku's got like 5, probably more. I haven't seen the whole series. He's all about helping people. He sacrifices himself so many times. Like, he died, like, I don't know how many times, like, a billion, I bet.
He's constantly dying
to save people. I would say Goku is the best natural girl.
Okay, good, good.
I argued that Jonathan Joestar from JoJo's Bizarre Adventure is the most magical girl. He fulfills the fabulous quota requirement all magical girls fairly handily with his various poses. He produces many sparkles through the use of his ripple magic that he uses against vampires, specifically Dio. He's the second most moe person this side of the Steel Ball Run, outside of Ariel and Speedwagon. And I think that's
good. Goku versus JoJo. Wow, how did we get here? Good. Okay, alright. Closing statement.
Alright, Joestar, pretty good, I'll give you that. But he does not have Goku in forms of transformations. And also, Super Saiyan is like all sparkles. It's like just glowing. So I don't think he can beat that.
Jonathan does go through a little transformation in the midpoint that I probably won't spoil because a lot of people probably haven't watched JoJo's.
You can't spoil JoJo.
That's why I can't say it. Everyone knows Super Saiyan Goku. Okay.
Alright, good. Here we go. Ready, guys?
Yeah.
Goku. Woo! Okay, alright. Now, guys, we have this leche pudding. Here, you guys like leche? I love leche. It's a great flavor of anything. Good fruit.
And so this is like our last big prize.
This is our last big prize.
We keep going. We don't have any more things.
Well, I mean, also, John, like, this is just a channel to talk about magical girls, too. Like, I mean, we've been talking about a lot of people that aren't magical girls, you know? But, I mean, there's like the whole, like, stereotype of magical girl being, like, a ditzy, fluffy, like, whatever. But I think they're pretty hardcore women fighters, you know? Like, what do you guys think?
That's
true.
Ooh, cool. And then I'm just build off of that. But, okay, we'll go to our final round. Here we go. Go. Hands raise. Alright, I pick Slim Moon. Let's get up here.
I pick that guy in the red hat.
Good.
What does Sailor Moon know about that?
I don't know.
Okay, that one.
Your headphones match your shirt. Okay, ready? And go.
I'm going to argue that Bash the Stampede is the best magical girl. Because not only does he transform, he goes throughout the entire Gunsmoke area and saves and helps in. Makes them feel. They learn about themselves and they heal. Not only that, he saved all of humanity by keeping these ships from like burning from his brothers.
Go.
The person I think is the most magical girl is Kari from Digimon Adventure and Digimon Adventure 02. On her team, she does not have a specific crest. It's the crest of light. But she sort of embodies all their traits. She is the picture of sort of innocence and caring. For example, one time she gets sick while her brother's playing soccer with her, and she apologizes for not being able to play with him well enough. So that's...
There you go, that's it. All right, closing statements.
Have you seen the scars on him and what he takes on for the people he saves and helps? He would more... willing to die than to see someone else die.
Okay. Of all that, now there are a lot of transformations in Digimon, but in Adventure in 02, it's not Kari herself, but it is her Digimon partner who does have the transformation that most resembles a magical girl's.
Okay.
Okay. See how you are dies.
All right, I would like you both to say the names of your chosen magical girls after Mike's.
Do you not know their names?
I missed it. Okay, I'm so mad. I heard Digimon and then who was
yours? Bash the Stampede.
Bash the Stampede. Okay, here we go. Bash the Stampede. Our Digimon girl. Woo! Cool. Alright. Kari, excuse me.
Here's your DJ plan. And you can get a bunch of candy.
Good. Ah. Wow.
Woo! Yeah.
Cool, good guys.
See, it's hard.
You're good.
Alright, round of applause for all of our contestants. We got about 20 minutes to do. 20 minutes left of our panel.
Bye, Debs. Bye. Okay, do we want to keep doing this?
Are you guys interested in doing this?
I have questions.
Oh, you have questions? I'd rather talk about magical girls. That's what I think. All right, speak.
Me?
Sure. Yeah.
All right. Well, I mean, I was curious as to why Madoka over here does not like Kill the Kill, but I think
that's not a discussion we're gonna go into.
I don't
today.
Think I can fight all of you at the same time.
I feel as though there's a greater question to be asked. There is what do you think the most important part about the whole genre of magical girl I kind of feel like it's a message of empowerment to, and basically every time it shows up, it's about lifting someone out of their normalcy into super normalcy.
Yeah, I mean, I think the magical girl genre is definitely about transcendence, but my biggest problem with Kill la Kill specifically is not, like, the message, but how it's conveyed. And let's just leave it at that. Like, I love Gainax, I love Trigger, I love, like, pretty much everything else they've ever done, but a Kill la Kill just makes me feel gross and awkward and uneasy. I don't like it.
Let's respect her opinion.
Talk about magical girls.
Magical girl relationships. Inuyasha versus Kagome.
Oh, God.
cool.
Good.
Wait.
Good. We really can't speak. I've seen Inuyasha like maybe 3 times at like 3 in the morning on Adult Swim.
I've seen Inuyasha a million times, and I think if you're comparing magical girls in that show, it'd be Kagome versus Kikyo.
Yeah. Is Inuyasha magical? He's like always a furry. He like never, he never like transcended. He's like always there, right?
And he's always a dick too.
Yeah, oh. I meant from versus. I meant how magical girls' relationships work.
Oh.
Magical relationships to each other, because there are a lot of shows where it's like there is one magical girl, but then there are a lot of shows where there's like there's two magical girls, and they're all magical girl and together. Relationships to magical
girls. I don't know. I don't think it's a magical girl series until they all like marry the one magical girl at the end. It happens like every
Moon.
Show. It happens in Sailor Moon. I think it happens in Madoka.
Oh.
Madoka.
Well, you would.
I don't think that's a requirement for a magical girl show though, but. Yeah. I think, you know what I also consider like a magical girl show? Like, Kiki's Delivery Service was one of the first things I've ever seen, like, ever. Like, I never considered it anime when I was younger because I didn't even know what any of it was. But, like, that movie inspired me so much, being, like, you know, 13-year-old girl on her own. She's got her magic. And it's about, like, she loses her inspiration and then comes back. And that's, like, a transformation of, like, you know, personal transformation that I think can apply to a lot of, like, magical girls.
A lot.
Yeah. Kiki. Love Kiki. Let's see. Do you want to talk about magical girls?
Can we talk about magical girl transformations?
I mean, sure.
Maybe. Cool. Like, that's like my favorite part of magical girl animes is like who has the best transformation.
I mean, my favorite part of magical girls, like when you say magical girl, it sounds like you're saying a bunch of sparkles at once. But it's like everyone thinks about it as such a light thing, but people take it so seriously, like we do, because I think it's a lot deeper and more important than that, because they're fighting for important things, so it can be applied to lots of different characters and aspects. Magical Girl is more of a feeling, emotion of what it is. I don't know.
Magical Girls is a feeling you get in your heart.
Yeah. There you go. If you walk away from this panel, anything should be that. And you can be a real life magical girl if you carry that feeling in your heart of doing good.
As far as transformations go, too, I find a really interesting one to be Princess Tutu.
Yes.
Because her transformation, arguably in the first season, she's not even in control of it.
Mm-hmm.
And sort of, you know, I mean, I suppose I shouldn't talk about the very end of the show, but it's definitely a more complicated relationship with sort of her coming to her empowerment and that sort of thing than the usual one.
I totally agree with that.
Yeah, I agree with that too.
Dave?
Pretty sure the best transformation is Kenshiro in Fist of the North Star.
Alright, you. Okay.
I was initially touched off by me thinking whether or not Shinji Ikari qualifies as a magical girl. I think he might, but then that got me thinking that could we consider mecha to be a sister genre to magical girl?
I think so.
Absolutely.
I think definitely.
And you talk about transformation sequences.
I mean that's what it is.
Lyrical
Nanoha
is a mecha magical girl.
Yeah, there you go.
Or Gatchaman Crowds. Like Kasumi.
Yes. Some Magic Knight Rare.
Yeah,
it's
good.
Hajime from Gatchaman Crowds is a mecha magical girl. It's absolutely perfect. Everyone should watch that show. But totally, like, what you're getting at, like, as soon as you said it, I'm like, Gurren Lagann. No. He becomes a man.
Yeah.
What do you have to say?
It was argued about Hikari from Digimon being the ultimate magical girl, but I think the magical girl in that series would be her brother Taichi. In the beginning, none of them had any intention of going to the strange world, but he kind of stepped up and led them, even through some opposition through Matt. And while he may not transform himself, his power within and his growth kind of is expressed through his partner. And in the movie, he wanted so badly to fight alongside and help defeat this threat that was going to literally, it sent a nuke, if you've seen the movie, and that he was able to enter the internet and fight alongside Omnimon.
Want to see the remake? Go watch some of
them. Cool! Convincing argument.
Suzaku Kururugi from Tokias, I feel, is a real-life magical girl.
Did you see those pop star figures in the dealer's room? The Code Geass pop star figures?
Oh, I didn't.
You didn't?
But
they had one of Lelouch with a microphone and then matching up with Suzaku and then Yuffie and Yuffie's sister. That was like, whoa, man, that's pretty cool. Wow. But no.
Yeah, like, I feel like he really goes through a transformation when he like learns all that's going on and everything behind what he knows.
Because of him, he just wants to do good.
Yeah.
You know? He is like pure do good. And then like, you know, Lelouch is like kind of like that main character antagonist sort of trope. So it's like, you know, we can talk about Lelouch being magical girl too, zero, like whatever, like that's a big transformation. But Suzaku is like the heart of doing good. So I feel like that's more the essence of magical girl. Yeah, I feel that.
Hinata Hajime is kind of a magical girl because he does kind of get a transformation sequence. And I mean, he's a bit snarky, yeah, but he does do what's best for everybody.
I totally agree with that. And I was like last night we went to one of the Madoka panels, and they were talking about like hope as being like an integral like part of you know, being a magical girl, mm-hmm. And that's why like Kyubi couldn't like make a contract with the witch because they have absolutely no hope. And I was like, Nagi, perfect magical girl material.
Nagi from Danganronpa, so just cops people from her. Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. So when we keep talking about like the spirit of a magical girl, mm-hmm. And it kind of it completely meshes with the spirit of a supergirl. And what we did when we started talking about like who could be a real life magical girls, we start immediately naming superheroes. So I'm thinking, I'm not very well versed in the genre, but it's Madoka, and dealing with obviously is there Kimono. But it seems like a couple of like staples of the genre are like the power gem, like soul gem, or the raging card, or I don't know what the calls it, and like a little animal helper. So is that like a carrying theme throughout all magical girl anime, or
yeah.
Is it just those three?
Yeah, pretty much. No, they're definitely like. I mean, magical girl animes just like borrow off of each other, but they transcend tropes. They're just like templates that magical girl animes sort of follow, like this like archetype. Like you have this like an item, an animal helper, you know, magical girl, the transformation.
And then like all like it's expanded a lot too. Like for example, like animal helper can be like totally. They like, bring back like, you know, Shuachara. Like their animal helper is like their internal dream self that follows them around, which is kind of, you know, a different idea of that.
Okay. Well, to kind of go with that, even though they are animals themselves, they have animal companions. My Little Pony. They have the. They have like. Oh gosh, I can't remember it now for some reason, but they all have something that.
Mm-hmm.
The elements of Parliament.
Yeah, that's perfect. Man, yeah, ponies and magical girls, we can talk about that. That's actually
Laura
really
Sparkle is the ultimate magical girl.
Yeah, that's perfect. You got the gem, you got the animal, you got good intent, friendship.
A teacher.
And I'm fairly certain by the end of the season they'll have a magical transformation. I'm fairly certain on that. Huh?
Well, that's a Harry Potter transformation.
Yeah, well, yes, but I'm talking all of them are going to go into something I'm pretty sure is called a rainbow mode.
They did that in the movie. They mentioned in the movie.
I feel like it's more abstract depending on like different series. Like, you know, Princess Tutu, is there an item?
There
are necklaces. There are necklaces. She's got a necklace.
And if she doesn't have it, she can't transform.
Uh-huh. Right, that's the point.
She can't be a human if she doesn't have it.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I think the item sort of represents something that, if you want to be a real life magical girl, is like internal. And, you know, it's just easier, you know, in a story, in an animated story, to externally manifest that in something. So, you know, Sailor Moon's locket, or her, you know, her weapon, Princess Tutu's necklace, you know, a soul gem.
I think it's more like something to ignite the transformation, if that makes sense. Like, you know, if you're going to be your real-life magical girl, how to, like, ignite yourself. Oh. Yeah, so I think that makes sense. Also, you know, like, in Kill la Kill, because, like, you know, her, like, blood gem sets it off. Like, that's kind of like her whole outfit's not exactly an item, but like, that's like the item that sets it off, which you can't have it without it. So, I think that carries on like all different types of series.
Andy's stocking.
Aaron's hand, there you go. That's item. Oh, sorry. It's painful.
Again, with Princess Tutu, do you think Miyuto would be a magical girl too?
Yeah, that makes sense. I mean, I haven't seen Princess Tutu in a long time, so I couldn't be, you know, very accurate in my opinion right now. But...
Yeah.
Good. Cool. Wait. All right. Cool. Hey, we've like we've only a little bit of time. We've got like, you know.
Y'all want to fight again?
Does anyone want candy that didn't get any? Because that's something people do with parents at the end. Yeah, there you go. This is like really good Korean candy I found randomly, and it tastes really nice. So you should just have some, or give it to your friends if you don't want any. Like, it's cool.
Sure.
So, this is a good discussion. I like talking about magical girls. You know?
I mean, I would take one call.
Hey, Hannah.
Yeah?
Thanks.
Do we have a hand back there, or a few hands went up a little while ago? And have anything you wanted to talk about? Okay. Cool.
I love your costume. Mm-hmm.
Have you seen Pokemon? No, I have not seen Pokemon. I should. I remember. No, I should, because, like, you know what, my friends have a Pokemon.
Basically, his power is that would be his magical power. That's cool.
And he does have a magical girl form, Denbo.
Hey, I feel that Jack Frost from Rise of the Guardians is also another very good example, because he forgets who he was, and he knows there's something expected of him, but he doesn't know what it is. Even though little kids can't see him, he still helps them and, like, brings joy to them.
Jack Frost is kind of funny, because, like, he's done the transformation, but he wants to find out, like, what he was before the transformation. That's almost backwards, but then he, like, overcomes that himself, and, like, you know, yeah. So he has his own internal transformation throughout that, gets his friends.
At the beginning of this panel, we were given a 4-stage ranking system for how close to being the ultimate magical girl.
Yes.
Now, who here in this room thinks that they were ranked 3 or 4?
Ooh.
I'm excited to figure it out. Joke. And why?
I always like to think the 4-stage ranking system of how to be magical girl. We talked about invisible magical girl, subtle magical girl, and I am magical girl. I am magical.
And you also have a 1 and 2 range.
Woo!
Yeah.
So, Homaro, at the end of the 3rd movie, without spoilers, where would you rank yourself?
Okay, well, I mean, we don't want to talk too many spoilers about Rebellion, but everyone go see the 3rd Madoka movie.
There's definitely magic involved.
Yeah.
And still a girl.
Yeah, I mean... Yeah. Because the thing is, at the end of this, the series of Madoka, she is not no longer a magical girl, she's a magical goddess. So if you want to get into that...
If you haven't seen Madoka by now, I think you deserve it.
So,
let's go back to the other
show. I mean, we've got a Madoka here, so I mean...
Yeah. I'm a walking spoiler.
Yeah, walking spoiler.
Sorry, y'all.
I mean, like...
Read the manga, and I'm still waiting for a single complete box set.
Yeah, and if you can get it, it's gonna be worth like $200
at
Cineplex.
She's right.
Yeah. I think Tsukimi from Yoshi's Princess is a magical girl. I'm so glad you said that. I love it because it makes you feel like any girl, no matter what size or.
Yeah.
Who's seen Jellyfish Princess? Jellyfish Princess is a real gem. I really appreciate that show a lot. Yeah, it's.
Whenever I get to see it. Oh, yeah.
It's not just girls.
I was talking about all of them in general because they're all nice people.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the whole show is for women.
Yeah, whenever I get into a sewing thing, I talk into that Philly princess.
Is Stephen Colbert a magical girl?
He is an entire country, you know. He is American.
I am a magical girl.
I mean, you could argue it. Why not? I mean,
he does put on his, like, Stephen Colbert persona. He's like a caricature of himself.
Not even a caricature of himself. He's just completely...
I wouldn't say no, but there's definitely hesitation in my nose. What's up, Pinkie Pie?
He went from Italia. That's what I thought of for magical.
Going back to Stephen Colbert, the opening sequence of the show is a pretty big magical girl transformation. Lots of flags and eagles and spinning. America transformation.
His mascot is an eagle.
Yeah,
that's his mascot.
There's animal helper.
And instead of like sparkles, he has 50 stars and stripes.
Yeah.
And a chicken hop sound.
And a sound.
That's not an eagle.
All right, hey, that was our panel. Basically, it concludes in 2 minutes, and this is really great. Anyway, I hope you guys had a really great detour, and it was really fun hanging out with you guys, fellow magical girls. Thank you, guys. Sure, if you'd like more candy, you're welcome to definitely come and get some candy.